Welcome to the online classes of Dipol School Joshipur. Today we will read about history of class 6. This is your book Viva ICSE History and Civics of class 6. In the previous class we studied about occupation, and in occupation we studied about agriculture, animal rearing, pottery, art and craft, trade, etc. Today we will read about art and architecture. So what is art and what is architecture? Both seems to be equal, but there is a certain difference between art and architecture. So let us see what is art. So art is nothing but the skillful creative activity which is mainly done as painted figures in stones or sculptures. So sculpted and painted figures on stone and clay were the main forms of Mesopotamian art. So sculpted means well shaped carved items on stones or by with the help of clay. So these figures are known as the painted figures. And by sculpting and painting figures on stones or clay, they figured out or you can say depicted various animals such as goats, rams, bulls, lions, creatures with both human and animal form, means half human and half animal form. You can see in this picture sculpture of a human headed bull belonging to the period of Assyrian Empire. Human headed bull is sculpted here on a single stone piece, you can say. Some other gods and goddesses, and as well as priests and worshippers. Some priests who perform the rituals, various rituals, and worshippers, those who worship their gods. So these are the items which are painted either on clay or sculpted on the stones. So this much is for art. And let us see what is architecture. So this was about art. Now let us see what is architecture. Architecture is the art and science of designing and managing the construction of buildings and other structures. This is called as architecture. So they introduced architectural features such as arches, columns, domes and vaults in buildings. So as we know that architecture is the art and science of designing the construction of buildings and other structures. So the design and the construction of buildings, to design or to construct buildings, they uses various architectural figures like you can say arches, columns, domes and vaults. So let us see what are arches. So arches, what is an arc? First we should know what is an arc. Arc is an inverted U-shape construction. An inverted U-shape construction is called arc. In the same way, columns. What are columns? Column is a solid upright structure designed usually to support a large structure above it. So when we I want to make one larger structure which is to be supported by any figure, that is a solid upright structure. A structure which is solid and upright structure to support a very big or large structure, that is called, that solid upright structure is called column. Next comes domes. So what are domes? Anything shaped like an upset ball, often used as a cover. Okay, so domes means anything it may be which is shaped like an upset ball. A ball which is ball, B-O-W-L, ball, ball which is upset, means often used as a cover. So when we use the bowl as a cover to cover any food items, in the same way this domes are also kept on the structure. Next comes vaults in buildings. Vaults means anything resembling such a downward facing concave structure, that is called vaults. So these are the things, arches, columns, domes and vaults. These are the architectural features which were used by the Mesopotamian people to construct their buildings, to design their buildings. So among them, two such eminent architectural hallmarks in Mesopotamian civilization are, one is the ziggurat. So as we know, ziggurat was a temple, you can say. It's a temple. So ziggurat is a temple which is built of bricks in the form of a layered platform. Layered platform, so a platform, you can say. Just have a look at this structure. This one you can compare with a ziggurat. Okay, so you see one layer, second layer, third layer, fourth layer. In this way a ziggurat was built. So you see the base is broader than the roof. Base is broader than the roof, the top. Okay, and another example of their architectural wonders are the tall, massive and strong walls built around the cities with prominent rampart. So the massive and strong wall which was built around their city, okay, with prominent rampart. Rampart means what? A defensive mound of earth or a wall with broad top and usually with a stone parapet. So that is called rampart. Okay, so the rampart, the ziggurat, and another one ancient structure, or you can say architecture, of the Mesopotamian people was the Hanging Garden of Babylon. So Hanging Garden of Babylon, it was built around 600 BCE. So the Hanging Garden of Babylon was built around 600 BCE before Christian era by King Nebuchadnezzar for his wife Amytis. So for Amytis, King Nebuchadnezzar had built this Hanging Garden of Babylon around 600 BCE. Why he made this one? Because she was missing her mountainous home. So Amity, the wife of King Nebuchadnezzar, her home was in a mountainous region where the natural look was very beautiful. But in Mesopotamian region, when she felt did not found that scenario of the mountainous home, she demanded King Nebuchadnezzar to build it. That is why King Nebuchadnezzar built the Hanging Garden of Babylon. The Hanging Garden did not actually hang at all. Okay, so the Hanging Garden is not hanging on the sky or anywhere else. It was a raised area of multi-level terrace supported by columns. Okay, so multi-level terrace, just like this. So different terraces were there, and in each terrace, plants and gardens are created in this way, so that it would give them a view of a mountainous view, natural mountain view. So this was also considered as one of the seven wonders of the world. And plants grew from this terrace. So from this terrace plants grew, and when the plants grew, it gave the impression or look that plants were hanging down from the top. That is why it is called Hanging Garden of Babylon. So this was about art and architecture of Mesopotamian civilization, and in the next class we will discuss about the religion and achievements of the Mesopotamian people. थैंक यू।